Members of Parliament have appreciated President Museveni's call to Ugandans to embrace the parish development model, which was rolled out in the financial year 2021-2022 on a promise of 100 per parish every financial year. They believe by coming out with a strong voice, the president is reviving the political and public will to support the progress of the program.
Emphatically spoken about socioeconomic transformation. He has spoken about PDM. And when he speaks about PDM, he automatically has to talk about agriculture. So he has emphasized the four-acre model and given examples which he has always given.
The president had a focus. Me, as an intellectual, if you want to address an audience, you must have a clear focus and the theme. His focus was very clear, was about parish development model and how it is linked to the socio-economic transformation agenda within the NRM manifesto and NRM vision. So that was very clear. He gave people hope. People thought that the parish development model is finished, it has collapsed.
Professor Elijah Msemeza, the Shema South legislator, hailed the president for packaging his message well by limiting it to the PDM despite other issues that are dominating headlines in the country.
Happy with the president, and he did not want to diverge into other issues which he said we shall have time to discuss. Because I can imagine if he started discussing corruption and other things, he would have been diverted. And another thing, as a politician, he has demonstrated that there is no crisis in the country. He's in charge. There is no crisis. He can talk on issue of social transformation and other issues can come later.
However, other legislators were caught off guard as they went to Kololo anticipating the president to pronounce himself on the iron sheet scandal where his ministers have been implicated.
I was expecting him to talk about it, but on hindsight, I'm also aware that tomorrow, Friday, the 17th, he has called an emergency cabinet meeting where he's going to discuss solely that item of the question, the history of iron sheets. And I think he doesn't want to be preemptive of what is going to happen tomorrow. You know, the president is somebody who is systematic. He's following step by step to see how all this happened, who did it, and what
has spoken. The president is one person who is very hard to predict. You can imagine there are so many million Ugandans that have expectations out of the president. Each of us expects something different. However, you might find that there is someone who thinks their expectations have been met, but there are those who say, mine have not been met. So it is two-way. We expect him to speak, but he cannot speak about each and everything at once.
Although the opposition in parliament announced a boycott on the presidential address, some opposition legislators showed up at Kololo. These include the Bokoto South MP, Dr. Twaha Kagabo, Bukonzo West Atikins Katushabe, among others. These explained why they defied the opposition.
And I didn't need to pick any courage to come here. Because when the people of Bokoto South elected me, they sent me to parliament to represent them. And one who represents them is attending parliamentary sessions and sitting. Okay? And this is one of them.
The opposition said it is entirely upon an individual MP to determine and decide whether to show up here or not. And I represent a community that is so passionate about PDM.
Kagabo emphasized that he has decided to follow his heart instead of collective responsibility of opposition, which landed him in hot soup when he returned the controversial 40 million shillings which was given to MPs.
The last time I tried to take people's opinions, I stepped on a landmine and nobody was there to detonate it. You saw it. Nobody was there to detonate that landmine. So this time I have always to invoke my intuition and to be guided by my
report compiled by Fred Kajubi for the news.